pull my shoes up. Morning, everybody. I've not got the chat open yet, so hang fire on your questions if you have any. Do you know what? I'm actually getting calluses on the inside of my fingers. Like, right in there. From holding onto the shifter. Like, gripping it when we're doing, like, hard races. Prolonged. It's not nice, is it? Those of you that have joined, welcome. I know some of you are heading off for work, I know some of you are going for a ride and everything else. So please don't let me keep you. You do your own thing. So as you've seen in the title, there's going to be multiple races. Come on, Sean. There's going to be multiple races today. It's not often I manage to find multiple races that line up as well as they do today. And when I say line up, I mean they're not so much tiring races. They're not flat out. They're not all like super duper aggressive races. Like this one now obviously is flat. It's not what you think, yeah. So it's not like they're all races. They aren't races, they're not races. Not races to me. I had to find a way of like keeping it humble in the title. And that's one of the ways of doing it, isn't it? It's not what you think. Yeah, not clickbait. Thank you.
your fault, guys. Jeez. Jeez Louise. What's going on? You said I was on the wrong scene, which you were right, but oh no. Oh, Zwift has crashed. Zwift has crashed. Oh, that's nice. Lovely. Sorry, guys. Thank you, Zwift. Beats me. Right, give me a second while I set it up again. Wonder if there's anything else on. I doubt it. I doubt there's any other race on though. No, there's no other race on. So yeah, that kind of ruins it. It's gonna be three races, and that messes up today's training. Sorry guys. We just sort this out before we get you back on the screen. Do apologize. I still ride with Matt. Still spin with Matt. Oh, he had to be here, didn't he? Had to be on the climb. Where is he at? It's 3 seconds up the road. Where's he gone? Oh, he's all the way up there. Yeah, that's my race simulation. Anyway, if you want to leave and come back, I totally understand. I know, I looked at a bit of a change in the sock front. Oh, good point, yeah, TT bike. Good shout, Mick, good shout. Oh yeah, actually we could do a mountain bike, can we? Should have a bit of a laugh. Should we do a motorbike? Should we see if we can catch Matt, who's just like up the road there? We'll try and catch Matt on the mountain bike.
out. And Zwift Mountain. Close. Right. Let's go. Yeah, look at me go. We'll easily do the challenge. How much of a difference would it make, like if I rode on the mountain bike in these races? I'd probably get dropped, don't I? Yeah, we're doing some ranked speed mission tomorrow, yeah. Welcome, by the way. Yeah, Scott. Priorities. Morning, David. Depends how much cake you have, innit? That's why you should weigh it. I'm joking. Ooh, Gus. There probably will be. I'm just getting at the wrong time right now. Oh, Phil, the epic tempo. Epic tempo is great. The epic tempo has just got like loads of different variations of tempo in it. Let's have a look here. Morning, Kev. It's actually not too hard, Phil. It looks like hell, but tempo is actually not, you know, it's starting to get difficult at the end for sure, but hang on, Gus, I'm on it. Right, tomorrow the DBR Suffer Day League, I've got penned in, Gus, if you're still there. And then I'm thinking of doing the Gaul ride again. The ride that we did on Sunday last week, I'm going to do it again on Sunday. To the ride on, Michael. Yeah, the Uber pretzel again, yeah. Just gonna ride it. Be a nice way to end the week. For me, anyway. Seem to go faster than 4 hours. Ah, there we are, sound. It's
two of us. Phil, you know you could definitely go faster on that course. I mean, think about it, last week you did a really big ride the day before, well, big ride, as in TSS wise, the day before it. So with a little less, you know, kind of fatigue in your legs, not dead fresh, but a little less fatigue, you definitely go under 4 hours by a bigger margin. But that's not to say you should do it this weekend, because of course you shouldn't push that board too much in a short space of time, because that's obviously overtraining. It's a fine line. Oh, we'll look after you, dude. Well, the plan for this live stream was to do four races, but that kind of we got kicked out of the first race by Zwift. They gave us a bad old dropout. I know. Well, that's it, see? Thing is, Phil, like, you don't know that side of things because, you know, you're still relatively new to cycling, but someone who we'd class as a weekend warrior, you know, they would only do like what you did on Sunday and absolutely smash themselves for 4 hours. Then they'd have to take 3 or 4 days off. And then they do the same thing the weekend after, and they just keep doing it. You know, those are weekend warriors. And I've seen them in my old cycling club, you know. That's all they do. And it's amazing how obviously little they progress. I reckon we should shave off at least 10 minutes. What do you reckon, guys? Like, you even think about the Alp. If Phil gets in a lot fresher shape, that's 5 minutes in itself, I'd have thought. You know? Weekend warriors look good, you know, don't get me wrong. Because, you know, you do have some big rides to pause on Strava or wherever it is. You know, it looks good. But when you ride just like 1 hour, 1 hour a day, every day for 5 days. Yeah, it doesn't look as good then, does it? But it's that. The Rafa Cycling Club have been doing like a knockout competition. The last few days they've been doing, they got the finals tomorrow. I think that's the one that Leo's been doing. So they had the semis last night, and they had like the quarterfinals or just the opens a couple of days before. So Tom, who you've seen a few times in the chat, Tom Shaw, he's also been doing, you know, that race that we've been doing recently on a Sunday, not last Sunday, but before that we were doing the Newbury Vela road race, I don't know if you remember. Well, he raced that a few times. First time he raced it, he set a new 20 minute power in the first 20 minutes, because it finishes on, well, not finishes, but that first 20 minutes finishes on top of Titans Grove. So he got dropped there. And then the second week, he's been setting PBs now for the last. He's a very strong rider in general, but he's getting caught out on the split. So the week after that, he did the Newbury Vela again. We weren't there, I don't think, and he lashed into the volcano. But he did some serious power there to stay in the group. And then this week he came top 15, I think, in that first round. And in the semis last night he came 7th, which is on the Dolphin, the downtown Dolphin course. And he's now made it to the finals. So he's like, he's over the moon, in fact, later. He's had like something to target there, you know, something to focus on. And it's funny how I see a lot of, well, not so much from you guys or the guys who, at least I, you know, I help out, but more so like the elite riders in the UK, you know, the professionals. I see them on Instagram talking about how, you know, they're quite, you know, they're quite low at the minute. Yeah, that's the one, guys. It's on the four horse one, yeah. Woo! Dig the grave. Dig the grave. Dig the grave. Gus is out now. Morning, Simon. So yeah, a lot of riders are very like demotivated at the minute. And they don't have any goals. And I feel like goals are very easy to set. Come on in, Mike. No worries, guys. It's understandable. Goals are very easy to set, you know. You've got to have... They've got to be big, but you can also have small goals. I think some people are afraid to set small goals. The big goals are amazing, you know. They're, you know, win a gold medal at the Olympics or, you know, win National Hill Climb Championships. Anything. But I think, you know, setting the small goals, you know, those are actually the ones that probably nobody knows about. And they're the ones that, apart from maybe you and your coach or you and your closest mates, or me and you guys, you know, those are the only ones that, that actually have meaning. And they're the ones that give you confidence. And it's funny, I spoke about it yesterday, but I'm watching the Netflix documentary series with Michael Jordan in the Last Dance, and I didn't know anything about, well, I knew Michael Jordan, you know, but I didn't know anything about Dennis Rodman or, you know, Pippen. And I think, you know, there's a lot of things that they say in that program, and they talk about like, they talk about a lot of things that actually kind of are almost like reality right now. And many people are, like a lot of riders I've seen on Instagram, you know, I've raced with in the past, and they're racing now, you know, they ride for, you know, the biggest teams in the UK, the professional teams, and they're struggling for motivation. And they haven't got any goals, and it's like, you do have goals, you're just gonna look in the smallest of details for them, and don't be afraid to make them really small. Like, this is the benefit that Zwift has, and I think, you know, when you race Zwift, or even when you just train on it, the goals can be very small and very achievable. What a great race that was. What a great race that was. Was that the sprint finish? Was it the sprint finish? I was riding for Mavic at the time. GLT Condor powered by Mavic. Maybe not. Because I know I won that stage. I can't remember which race it was. And it was a breakaway. There was like four or five of us and I won the kick. I'm sure I raced the RAS later that year. I've loved racing in Ireland, I have to say. Yeah, Johan, I did that booster program. I did it. Oh, I told you when I first started getting into cycling, I did it. You have to remember though, perspective here before you jump on the 31 watts in 2 weeks. Perspective. So, the training that you do now won't come into effect until, on average, 4 to 6 weeks later. So the training that David's done there won't really benefit him until his body's adapted to it further down the line. Now, that's not to say he hasn't adapted to it already, but the chances are doing those efforts when you haven't done them in the past in that kind of structure, that's dragged him already. That's given him that level already, and that's perfectly normal. But I think he's likely to see a bigger improvement further down the line, even if he doesn't touch on any of those efforts now for the next 4 weeks. I think his body will adapt to them fully. So always remember to be patient when you're following the training plan. But of course, like, that program is super intense. So what you end up doing is, you're working these like really upper range zones for 14 days. And psychologically, it's just like doing a stage race. So when you do a stage race, what happens is, the day after the stage race, you get what's called stage racing legs. So you can still, like 200 watts feels like 100 watts. That's what a stage race does for you. That's what racing does for you. And that's what hard efforts do for you daily, daily, daily. It's almost like the norm. So what's happened there with David, yes David, I can see you. You've just been supercharged in a very short term because you've pushed that envelope. So you're likely to see even more of a gain later. Oh, Cook's tongue rings a bell. I'll tell you what, hey Alex, you see some aggressive racing in Ireland. You see some really aggressive racing. There's some great roads for racing, like very aggressive roads, and it makes for really entertaining racing. There's always something happening. That's why we always enjoy coming over there, because the Irish would always give you a good race, always. And that's always been the case, I think. Charlie's dad, who's like 70 now, when he used to race and they went over to Ireland, yeah, he still speaks to me now, like some of the hardest races he ever did were in Ireland. It's a fact. What do you mean, Mario? I practiced 20 straight Zwift races, or 20 minutes, 90% of FTP. Because if you're not used to it, if you're not used to that effort, Mario, then it's like me going out and running for like five kilometers now, and like I'm completely ruined for like 3 days, if that's what you mean. So if you haven't done that effort in a while, then it may be that. Yeah, it's relentless, yeah. Yeah, it is relentless. It was so good. The RAS is up there, man. The RAS is really up there. It's one of the best races I've ever done. I'm a three-time man of the RAS. It's amazing, like, the roads that you have. I wonder what the Super Tug looks like on this bike. Oh, why is he up in the Super Tug? Bit of a letdown. Well, we've got a couple of races lined up now after this, well, after this ride. I could do one of them on the motorbike, but surely there's too much of an advantage. 20 straight days. I don't think it doesn't matter what intensity you ride at. It's gonna hurt, like. Like, it doesn't matter what intensity you ride at for those 20 days, I think they're still gonna take a lot out of you. Particularly if you don't have a rest day. Yeah, you've just gotta be a little bit careful, Mario. Like, sometimes it's good to push through, but other times you've gotta remember that the rest that you have is actually what's making you stronger. The training days don't make you stronger, well they do, because that's obviously the work you're putting in, but the rest days are the most important days. And I know it's hard for a lot of people because they work and or they sit at the desk all day and they, you know, they shorten their hamstrings and everything else that comes around with it, but the rest days are, well, back when I started cycling, like, a rest day was like, I'd still ride, and that's got a lot to do with my youth. But then when I joined and I saw like Christian House and Ed Clancy, Graham Briggs, Russ Downing, James McCallum, what else am I leaving out? You know, these experienced riders, I think then it was that I learned, like, you know, you've got to have like really easy days. How do I think I'd get on in the Pro Zwift race this week? Would I smash them? I don't know, what do you reckon? I watched Pritch's... video analysing Greg Van Avermaet's race. And I don't think it looked too difficult. You can do, Jake, you can do faster rides or low intensity rides, but everybody's different. Like, so long as you ride easy, then there's no problem. That's right, Alex, yeah, it's difficult because, you know, at the same time you're like, you know, you are pressed for time, you know, you've got to be empathetic, you're pressed for time to train, and therefore you want to make the best of it, and that's why a lot of people end up training and not having rest days. Well, Mario, your body's got used to riding every day, I suppose. But what did you do on that rest day? Did you sit around all day? Did you just sit around all day? Because you might hear sometimes, if you watch the Tour de France, but then I wish they'd give you a better insight, to be honest. But when you watch the Tour de France, you know some riders, you know when they head into the mountains and they get a really, really hard day on the bike on a Sunday, mountain top finish, they empty the tank. The next day is a rest day, and then they ride in the high mountains again the day after. Some guys crack. They crack completely, regardless of what they've done that rest day, whether they've taken it off or whether they've gone, you know, really hard. Some guys just do not respond well to a rest day. They do not respond well to it. So that's where, you know, the personalized approach comes in, like who needs what. So that's why some guys crack. Cheers, Lord. Mario's already emailed me a few times. We're actually in communication. Hey, thank you, Troy. What time is it with you right now? Which side of Oz, you based? I've got family on both sides. Perth and Gold Coast. I'll have to come over. You have to remember as well, put this into perspective. So Mario has just done a huge block over 20 weeks. What he's done is overloaded. So there's a big overload of training, and his kind of his form of fatigue, they've just been getting further and further apart, and he's putting himself in a hole. What happens then is you take one rest day and you expect to be like fresh as a daisy and back to it. But if you apply the principle of training takes 4 to 6 weeks to kick in, it doesn't matter if you take one day off or 5 days off. You're likely to still feel terrible after that 5 days. See what I mean? So, it's so complicated, but just thinking about it, you know, those 20 days, you know, you're probably not gonna start feeling good until a week after. You know, if you did the Tour de France, some guys, they don't come round for like 2 months after it. You know, they put themselves in such a big place. So think about it that way. Yeah, don't we all? We all need a recovery week after watching the tour. Recovery week from food and drink. From all the time we've just spent watching it. Well, I'm listening to an Amazon playlist in a minute. And it's my most listened to songs. And at the minute, we're listening to I Carumba by Get Lizzy. So I apologize at how gangster that is. I'd like to, Zach. Yes. There is a crossover though between the Taiwan KOM and the National Hill Climb Championships. So, you know, there's a crossover. So I either ride one or the other. Taiwan, if it goes ahead, you know, I'll ride it. If it doesn't, then Nationals is priority. The problem is, of course, that the difference between Taiwan and Nationals is like, yeah, there's like one that's 5 minutes and one that's like 3 hours. So if I want to go well in Taiwan, I cannot expect to go well at the Nationals. I just cannot. Two different states. That's a good question, Simon. Well, funny enough, yeah, Mario, that sometimes it's not as simple as, you know, if you feel good, you feel good, but sometimes it's not simple. It's a weird one. Once you delve into cycling, training and things like that, and you know, physiological changes, everything else, it becomes a lot more complicated than just going out and riding your bike. And you know, everyone responds different, and you know, that's what makes it complicated. Thing is, sweet spot has its place, but it has to be relatable to your end goal. If your end goal is to ride the Marmot, so Phil, for example, bike racing up Nursey. Oh, by the way, Simon, I was going to say, riding basically 3 weeks of the Tour de France on Veloton looks appealing. Do you know the actual sort of plan stages and things? That was actually like, I did send them a message, but I haven't heard anything. So maybe like you guys could go and holler at Veloton and get them to basically do what Chris has done, but obviously I would do it like over 3 weeks. Everyone does, Mario. Everyone does. Well, not everyone, but it's difficult. Nutrition and everything like that, to get it on point. There's a lot of experimenting to be done. So yeah, speaking about... Yeah, wouldn't it be, Simon, wouldn't it be? I'd love to give it a stab, even if it's just the short stages. You know, the when you dumb it down so that it's not full length. I think doing that would absolutely ruin the indoors. Next race. We're doing three after this, dude. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh yeah. So sweet spot. It has a place. If your end goal requires it. So things like Phil, Bike Race Without Mercy. It's at like nine-ish, so like 10 minutes or so. Yeah, I was going to say, Phil Lovett is doing the, he wants to do the Marmot, you know. That's, what that requires is, you know, the Galibier, Alpe d'Huez, you know, all these big climbs, and for him to actually complete it at his best capacity and to get over the climbs as fast as possible without burning matches, but then also getting over them as fast as possible, you know, he'll want to ride them a lot of the climbs that are an hour, you know, hour and a half. You know, he wants to get to a place where he's capable of replicating like a 90% of FTP for an hour and a half, resting for 30 minutes and then doing like another 45 minutes at 90%. So he's riding at that capacity for a long period of time on these climbs to get over them as fast as possible. So, you know, in terms of road racing, it's different because you're almost constantly fluctuating. But when it comes to like sportives and Grand Fondos, it becomes a little bit more personalized and easier to target. Paul, we've actually been given guidelines from the Welsh government. You're only allowed to ride within 5 to 10 miles of home. So, are you? Whereabouts are you? You're in England, are you? So, we're not like, I don't know why we've been given different rules. Because, like, we're actually a lot more rural than England, and we've had like hardly any deaths. So it puzzles me a little bit. Looking forward to the weekend and seeing what new rules and regulations we have. No, I haven't had an email back from Wahoo yet. That's right, John. So Johnny's from back home, same cycling club as me. And we spoke a lot about it, like in the build-up, like how you tackle something like that, but also working on the weight side of it, isn't it, John? So like obviously when people have weight to lose and they want to give themselves, it's all about giving yourself the best chance of being as fresh as possible when you come to Alpe d'Huez. Just like you would in a real race, you know. You don't want to be burning unnecessary fuel before you get to that last climb, because, you know, Alpe d'Huez, man, after that amount of time in the saddle, you could be spending like an hour, hour and a half on the flipping thing. So, it was all about getting those guys to the finish as fresh as possible, just like in a road race. But it's a lot easier in a Grand Fondo. Because you're actually in control to a certain extent. Is that right? Is that right about the exercise time should be lifted? 21 kilos. Yes, Paul. I know. Don't even go there. Well, funny enough, Johnny's missus works in healthcare. Charlie soon, hopefully. So I guess we come at it from a different perspective, but I know, Paul, I know. I miss them. I do miss them. And it'll be even more, do you know what I mean? When we get back outside again, you're gonna love them even more, you know? And I'm gonna love them even more. Because it'll just be so nice to get back out in the sun with the wind, you know, descent. Oh, this guy's got a turbo trainer, look. He's dragging his turbo around him. Oh no, he's gone. So it'll be nice. I apologize, Paul. At least you can chat to me a bit more here. What's that, Sean? Oh, the marmot. Nice, that's a good time. That's a really good time. Is that Koto jacket? That's what everybody says. Is that Koto jacket? Yeah, that's it, isn't it, John? Same, yeah. Yes, Ryan, I remember it. That's actually one of my favourite climbs. One of my favourite. Like, I drove there 2.5 hours to do it, and I think some people knew. I think some people knew I was coming to do it, but I actually got beaten by blanking on his name now. He came third, he actually ended up coming third in the Nationals. Oh god, what's his name? Richard Bussell. Big old time trialist, but very good hill climber. And I lost to him. Yeah, we still keep in touch with John, actually, Bob. Send me a couple of messages every now and then. We exchange messages. He did a bike ride the other day as well, which is nice to see. He's first time we went to Australia, which that would have been my first time I went to Australia. And he took his bike with him. And we were there for 2 months and he only rode it once. I was like 2013. Sorry, Ian. Yeah, he's a lovely guy, Paul. He's a lovely guy. Stayed at his house so often, like, just to feed me and let me train, like. It's like staying in Belgium, but staying in Middlewich, you know? I have to say, I'm also like a big fan of Zwift. Well, I was. But like, the thought of me riding on it every day was like, And then when I finally, like, had to do it for this, not had to do it, but made the decision, it's actually not so bad. Ah, Robert Hobbs, yeah. Nice to hear from you, Norman. Yeah, Robert Hobbs. They put, there's a good memorial race on for him and everything. Unfortunate death in an accident on his bike, but still a very good rider from the local area. Everybody knows him, everybody remembers him. Ah, yeah. That's a small world, isn't it, Paul? Yeah, all these doors of him, yeah. The Strava existed back then. Yeah, yeah, stop riding this gear. Coming down them's fun though. I bet that was a trio to be fearful of. Molly Phillip, yeah, we're okay, thanks. You're just in time for a race, guys. Those of you that just joined. So we've got some I bet you did. Some rubbing. No, I can't say I have. Jonathan as well. When did you move to North Wales then, Norman? Sorry, apologies. Apologies. Yes, Philip. I know plenty of people who've only just started doing structured training in their 50s, seeing big improvements. We're on the Wahoo Kickr 18. That's what we've always been on, really. I think I better join this event, actually. Otherwise I'll be at the back. But first we're going to get some free downhill. Me mountain bike. Oh. Don't forget to change the bike as well before we jump in. We'll not go down that. Yeah. Cheers, Mick. You're absolutely on it. Fair play to you. You got it, Phil, you got it. Thank you, Phil. By the way, now I've got some of now I've got some of you here. Scott, who most of you know, is in charge of these really, really nice thumbnails that we've been popping up recently. Scott's got a YouTube channel, KOM Hunt TV, or Com Hunt TV as I like to call it. I like to call it KOM. I don't know if Scott knows this actually, but on the side of my Hexa helmet, I've got KOM on the side of it. He's probably going to love that. I'm going to tell him. But yeah, while I've got your attention, while I've got you here, just before this race, he's done some designs for us for t-shirts. So I'd love to share them with you guys. And we're going to, I'm going to do a video today. And, well, I say a video, I'm going to record a video today. I don't know if it's going to go up today. But yeah, I'm going to show you the designs. And we've got a couple to choose from, as you'd expect, because the man is an absolute legend. And you're welcome to chip in and comment and choose your favourite, because at the end of the day, you know, we did discuss it and we were like, you know, I like this one, blah, blah, blah. But then I thought, you know what, it was actually you guys that decided that this would be a good idea. So, why not open it up to you lot? So if you want to, I can do that.
Join event.
Multitasking here. Yeah, there's an ed mode. There's different designs for ed mode. There's also one that just has like a little logo on it. There's a couple of others as well. So anyway, I'll put them all on a video. You'll be able to see them clear and clean on a screen. So hopefully you'll enjoy what he's created. I certainly like it, but I wasn't able to say for definite like which one I like the best. So I figured they'd open it up to you lot. And we're kind of in. We have two options at the minute. With making the t-shirts, I'm thinking of making them under my brand of Lab Rat Coaching, so I could have them outsourced and made. We can have them on the Band of Climbers website, so you can easily purchase them on there. And you know, Scott will have a little shout out on there as well. But I think you like the designs. I don't want to push it too much because I'm very respectable of your money and your time, and I don't want to push you to do anything. But yeah, I just thought that opening it up to you and showing you what we've created would be the best option, if you agree. So yeah. Yeah, the Edhead bobbleheads are a bit recent. Yeah, we'll definitely have those. I'll put them on my mind map. Cheers, lad. I know the big guys out here in the chat, you know, Gus, Quentin, Niels, but they've played a big part in it as well. So shout out to them. No Tron, David. No Tron. Actually, I'm going to go for a quick toilet break. I've got 2.5 minutes left. So what do you think? You guys okay to watch that video and have your say? I'd greatly appreciate it. Oh, the Bulk of Grace is some kind. The Bulk of Grace is some kind. That would create great content, I have to say. Do you know what we'd have to do actually?
with both of Royce, we'd have to record it all, create some great content, of us just staying in a really rough, like B&B or something, and it's like raining and windy and like gritty and grimy, and then we head out there and we climb like probably one of the hardest climbs in Wales. Like it's so steep for so long. That would be absolutely mental. And then obviously I'd try and go for the KOM. And Scott would go for the downhill KOM. Alright, nice one. Appreciate it, guys. Appreciate it. Here we go then. We've done an hour. We're on the right bike. Well, we're on a bike. Whether it's the right one, we don't know. Alright. Yeah, worst conditions ever. We need the worst. We can't do it on a nice day. It's not right. Alright. Oh, downhill wet KOM, can you imagine that? Disc brakes for the win. This is part of our workout today, so. Oh no, it's gonna end. Hang on, Johan. That's the one. This is a good race in that it's allowing us to press on just to stay in the draft. So I'm getting what I want out of it. Yeah, that's not right. I heart rate. It's not even that long, I'm sat on the sofa. We might try and win the last race. We'll see. We're gonna play it by ear. I'm in like 53, 15, 14. You'll have to wait and see, David.
Love that lot. Can you easily use the 50-34? As in, can you easily push 50 and 11 on the back? If not, I would stay with that. Gears don't make you stronger, by the way. Just in the same way that resistance on your trainer doesn't make you stronger. It's the power output you do, and hence the training, that makes you stronger. If you run out of gears, then yes, you know, change to a harder gear. Well, three races actually, really sorry. We got booted out the first one. Zwift crashed. Yeah, go for the 52 then. Oh, there's a split there. Ooh. My word. There's a bit of a press here. Got that right, Stuart. Oh. Up some tips, Dave. Hard, right? On left. Roll it, Maximus. Hey, there's a Hobbs in this race. Two. Well, one actually, but nice one, Phil. How old are you, AS? I bet you're young. Phew, I can't hold it. Still 5 minutes off your peak on average. You'll get there. Go on, Phil. Last one. Last one, best one. Eased off now. Amazing, actually. When we did that ride on Sunday, we come along here, we were doing like 45k now. Like two, like, in a race we're doing 47. Big difference. Hey buddy! Lightweight! Ooh, Zone 5 60-30s. My favourite. Sit on now. Sit on. Well, for dinner tonight, we're just gonna have chicken. I love chicken. And some BBQ sauce. Gotta get the protein. I can feel. I don't feel it. Oh, nice, Amos, nice. Oh. Yeah, big fail. Fasted is hard, man. Arrow. No. Don't want a feather. I'm using stream labs, Norman. One minute, pal. That's right, Guzman. Yeah, Kurt tries it again. It's unbelievable, isn't it? You must love racing against me. It's nice though, it's nice you can have somebody familiar, you know what I mean? Trying to make too many efforts today, so a lot of these races are flat and therefore require very little matches burnt. Yeah, remember. Tomorrow we've got a good race. Above the Zwift. So, on the four horseman loop. So that should end. That should be quite an entertaining race for you. So today, it's more of like an upper endurance type of ride with these races. I haven't, no. Enlighten me, Jake, enlighten me. Morning, Peter. Nice one, Ruben. Nice one. Come on, then. Tell me. All right. Oh, you've gone mad, yeah. In a good way. Okay, then, sir. Thank you, Johan. You hear the man. Nah, the Wahoo mat is back at home, mate. So I can't get it. Like Captain Morgan there, look. I know, isn't it? Kickr, Norman, Kickr. Ah, 75%.
Come
That's brilliant, Jake. That's just what we're doing, Zach. It's very rare that four races can usually land back to back and be flat enough for me to be able to ride them polarized, as in zone two the majority of the time, and then hard for short amounts of time. So it fits in really well when I want a longer session on it all. Two left, Lord. I'm only doing two after this one. I had the flywheel vibration. I had to send it back as well. Yeah, that's it, Lord. The noisy one. Yeah. Are they amateurs? Yeah, they are my gear. Leo is good enough to be I won't be doing any attacking. Next. Yeah, they're, well, this is the thing, they've both got the power, haven't they, to be pros, or well, you know, that level. So, but there's lots of riders I got on Zwift. You know, I don't have the pro badge. But I much prefer the elite rather than pro. Yeah, I prefer being called an elite athlete rather than a professional athlete, even though I don't get paid. It's kind of lost its value to me over the years that, you know, running for a team and getting paid, like, it's what you love to do, so yes, you get paid for it, but really it's what I'd be doing anyway. I always used to say, like, this is what I'd be, well, what I'm doing now is what I'd be doing when I'm 65, you know? I'd be riding my bike, I'd be racing, like, time trials and whatnot. Would Jake. So the next race is Volcano, yeah? And then we finish off in Innsbruck. With the short punchy climbs. what do you guys watch me for? You can be as brief or as detailed as you like, but what do you get out of watching
watching me, not necessarily the Zwift racing or the Zwift training, like in general, the muffins. Because I'm interested to know, because of where I want to go. You know, I have an idea in my head of what I want to do, like in the next 5 years. I just wonder whether or not it corresponds or correlates to what you see or what you have a noise watch. So if it is learning, and if it is, you know, just the fun or you know, the little tips that you picked up just at a random place or something, then because very few people say to me that they follow me to watch me like just do another race. I know it's different on Zwift. It's different on Zwift, but I was thinking taking outside the Zwift thing. I think the applying yourself. Yeah, the applying yourself. Because what I want to do over the next 5 years, I'll give you a little bit of an insight, is I want to give myself projects that I can dedicate myself to, like I did with the British Hill Climb Championships, and really showcase this is the starting point, this is what we have to work with, this is the end goal of an end goal. I think I'd like to do more of that, you know, 2 to 3 times a year if possible, while I have this ability to do it, you know what I mean? After the British Hill Climb Championships, I was lucky enough to have this, and have, you know, brands come up to me and say, you can do this, like, we'll do this for you, we'll do this for you, we'll do this for you. And I've almost had to, this year, have like a transition, an experiment to see, is it possible to do this? Is it possible to race? And because the racing hasn't happened on the road, because we haven't been racing on the road, it's kind of allowed me to have that experiment even further. You know, like this is what we'd be doing. Like if I wasn't racing, road racing, for an actual elite team, this is what I'd be doing. No, I wouldn't be riding Zwift every day, but you know, this is what my life would be. And the after Zwift attempt a few weeks ago, which broke a number of records, both on my YouTube channel and, you know, I'm still feeding off it now, that replaced what we were going to do at Saclobra in Mallorca, and that was to break, you know, some, well, Team Sky's riders KOM, you know, that replaced that. So this is what we'd be doing, and I feel like I can offer you a lot more in that respect, rather than the racing side of it. I can do the racing, I can race. And like racing takes on many different terms, doesn't it? Like you can race yourself, you can race on Zwift, you can set yourself a goal to, you know, to race up after Ez or to set a new PB up a climb, and that in itself is a race. You know, so racing is competitive, but it depends where you get that competitive edge from, you know, because there are pros at that level, you know, like Dowsett, Willie Smith, you know, these guys that ride that level, and they are on YouTube and they record it, and they show you what it's like there. Maybe Ed. Yeah, I appreciate that, Jason. By the way, I did see all your comments. I did see all your comments. I was talking and reading at the same time. I wasn't ignoring you. So part of what we're doing this year is creating that ability
to make that step next year, and of course the end of this year if events happen. Thank you, Philip. Thank you so much. Yeah, I defend it, Zach, yeah. Yeah, that's a great idea, Ruben. I don't know if you've seen in the comments below, not in the comments, in the description below, guys, but you can join a mailing list for like some Zwift rides that we'll do or some workouts that we'll do. It doesn't have to be workouts, it can be Zwift rides as well. So just drop me an email and I'll add you to the email list, which is growing. We've got like 20 people on it already. My target is to reach 100. Yeah, very well put, Matt. Very well put. I don't want to fall down that rabbit hole, but I want to come at it from a different point of view. So it's different for me, I think, Matt, because I'm like 10 years younger than Phil. Not 10 years, but you know, a little bit younger than Phil. So whereas Phil has had this kind of, you know, he's been world tour and he's raced at that high level, and you know, now he's coming down to that level, I think I have possibly a different edge to it, being still quite young. I believe, you know, 26 this year, I've still got like 4 or 5 years where I could possibly dedicate myself to something very, very small. She has got a lot of purple in there. Well, the thing is, Michael, there's things that we can do, you know, there's things we can do. Like, me and Phil were talking about going out to do the Marmot, but we can definitely do like the Attack to Tour. And when we do the Attack to Tour, you know, I can do the whole stage, and I can try and set, you know, the best time on the whole stage. I can try and, you know, smash a KRM on route, you know, in these actual events, you know, because I'm almost like young enough to be able to do it, and have the drive and the ambition to try and target that and do it. Yeah, should definitely do that. Should definitely do that. Ruben's been talking about that event. Yeah, true, Matt. True. But it's important not to get too caught up in that. I think I've got this idea that cycling sponsorship could change in the next few years because of what's happened this year, and because of what has been happening in the past with sponsorship. So it'd be really interesting to see that in, you know, in a couple of years' time, maybe when I'm still only 29, you know, if we do become kind of the name for doing these sort of things, then you almost wonder whether teams would change their sponsorship model. And instead of employing riders for 1 year contracts, things like that, but they'd employ them for month contracts. You know, I want you to do these two races this month, I want you to do them, and we're gonna employ you for 2 months and you ride that. It's an interesting concept that I've thought of there, but it does make you think how contracts work, and contracts in cycling don't really mean anything. I have to tell you that as well, that's my opinion, but they don't really mean a heck of a lot, because if a team is owned by sponsors and those sponsors pull out, then it doesn't matter if you sign a 1 year deal or a 5 year deal. If there's no team, then your contract means nothing. So it's an interesting, you know, there's no kind of like security there in that, then, you know. So hence why I want to build this little thing that we have. And also give you, you know, the entertainment and the drive and the discipline to be able to go up there and do your own little
goals and ambitions as well.
Yeah, you got a point there, Jason. It's interesting, like, that's just an open, you know, that's an open discussion, isn't it? It's an open debate, but it'll be interesting how it'll work.
Yeah, so this course is the same course we did yesterday,
I think.
It's a whole lot of lava, so I'm guessing it, isn't it? It goes up the volcano twice and then descends down the bridges. I think it's less... Hopefully there's less strong riders in this. I'll have a quick look here.
I don't think they'll sponsor YouTube channels, but I think they won't just look at riders who are racing in the divisions and then professional teams. I think they'll start looking elsewhere. Because you can't ignore people. You can't ignore people. In a world that's run by social media nowadays, you know, I don't think you can ignore people, you know? Especially with Zwift as well, because you don't even have to be streaming to know who the heck is on there. See what I'm saying? It's good to keep options open though, like, I mean... Yeah, this is the exact same race, guys. This is an exact same race.
Oh, Ed Morgan's racing. Good old Ed. Ed's from my cycling club. He's from Bynea. He's probably going to brawl us in the sprint.
Yeah, that's it, Mick. Riders should become more of a brand. I think it's easier to create a brand and then do what you want with it rather than doing that and then trying to become a brand. Unless you're Sagan or Cavendish or any of the others, then I'm sure it works.
I remember that epic moment that Froome broke away. Yep, sir. That's not very often that you see somebody with roughly the same surname as you. Joe Laverick.
We'll give it a nudge, this one. We'll give it a nudge. Battle of the Eds. Thank you, Jason. That's really appreciated. What's going on with this camera angle? That was weird. Ah, just remembered, I've got my 808 in. It's not going to help me up the climb. Yeah, go do that, Michael. Definitely for the best. Sorry, David. You are the man to listen to. Yeah, no, I'll just wait for the sprint again. Well, I'm trying to time it a bit better. Good practice, huh? Beat the pole easier. What's that, Jake? We'll have to go out and see Vegan soon. Go and ride with him. Do some KOM stuff. Ah, yeah. Cheers, Lord. I don't know, Conker. My pleasure, Jake. Well, it's not on me anyway. Sorry, also. Do I talk poo? Poo poo. Attack! What are you talking about? The car drafted me. I was expecting them to come over the top there with me, but maybe they're just playing it safe. Phil, I had your email as well, by the way. What would you rather do? What would you rather do? How long would it take to drive? Because obviously you're going to factor in tiredness from travel. If he wants the comm good, it'll have to be playing with it. Oh, I've nearly caught them. There we go. That's a good old Leo trick, that one. Just stretching and resting. See if we can do 2 watts per kilo now to stay in the group. Phil, did you hear my message earlier? About driving down to the Marmot in the Land Rover or flying down. Think of it from your perspective with the fatigue of driving. I don't know what your options. What do you think about it? How long it would take to drive. haven't got no power ups in this race. At least it was smart. So what do you want to do, Phil? Everybody spam Phil, because he's not answering. Phil, I said it about 3 times and about 5 minutes ago. While you were talking about cars. Your email about driving down. Would you want to drive or fly? Thank you, Lord. A bit short of breath here. This is why we do four races, or three races. Is when you start getting into the nitty gritty of it, that's when you have to push yourself when everybody else is fresh. It makes a difference. I'm not worried about those three. I'm not climbing so well today. Not now anyway. Not 2.5 hours in. Slowly catching it, but be interesting to see when we come close here. Thank you, all slow. Here we come. Yes, we will sprint, I think. Well, we'll see. See what legs we've got left. Feeling a bit cack now. And the glob's doing us some favours here, isn't it? It's nice not to be on the receiving end of it. I'm sweating. It's so warm today around this volcano. It's coming back, but somebody's going solo. Should make for a tasty finish here. We're in a handy position, being dragged by this blob. Gonna stand on the trainer.
Hmm?
Gonna stand on the trainer.
Do I need to stand on it now?
In about 30 seconds. Ready?
Yeah.
Oh, get off. It's going to be a close one. What's our predictions? You jump across. Ah, legs. Gone. Ha.
Come on. Well done, monkey legs.
Legs just go, guys. They just buckle. It's like when you get to that high end at the end, you gotta think. I'm not fazed by it because when you put it into perspective, we're 2.5 hours into this with a number of races back to back, and we're also like in the middle of the block that we did yesterday and last few days, so yeah, my legs are like that this morning time when I got out of bed. Yeah, we're 2,000 kilojoules in, so even to be able to sprint like off the back of these like prolonged rides of it's starting to eat into us now. So yeah, a little spin now, and then we'll join the next event. This will be our last event. Last event of the day. I'm just going to change my trainer settings. Let's put it here because I hear that a lot of the big top names in Zwift right there. So we're going to put it there and see what difference it makes in Innsbruck. Have a look at the graph. So you can see, like, the snap wasn't even that big when we went. And then we couldn't even get a butt out at the end. And heart rate is super low. But it wouldn't reach peak anyway for me in a sprint. I'd never reach peak heart rate usually in a sprint. I usually reach peak heart rate in a prolonged maximal effort. A couple of beers, yeah. Yeah, you're right, it does need to show a number, doesn't it? So we've got two more bars here, we're just gonna eat them now, both of them. It's gonna be 40 grams of carbs. We've had around about 40 grams an hour this morning. So like I said, it'd be just 3 hours 15 I think today. So just had a message from Joe Laverick. Always playing games. Oh, nice. Someone's just bought Van de Climber's vest, and they've just tagged me in it, which is really nice. New base layer. We got some couple of ideas. Well, thanks for joining, Conker. We'll see you soon. Sleep well. Hi, Giorgio. Do you know what? We've got some plans, you know, when this lockdown ends, we've got some plans for going up to the Lake District. Obviously, the boys from Cycling Hub are up there. And, we're going to get Bynea Climbers to come over. We're going to do some shots, do some calming. Inside or outside, Joel? I've actually done, well, I've never done one inside. Refill. Funny you say that, Lord. We were definitely thinking about doing a handicap. Maybe we should open it up for people to come along. Hi, Moshi. To start our accommodation and everything. Start our accommodation. And get a hotel and put you all up. Cheers, David, definitely will.
Well, we've done two. The first one, the game crashed, so we didn't do the first one. So we're only doing three now, not four. Why not, innit? Thank you, Machine. It's down to you lot. Nothing to do with me. Oh yeah, clickbait. You got nothing to clickbait about, that's the thing. Yeah, I can't wait, yeah. I don't think he's ever raced at Ruben. I don't think he would either, would he? Oh, I don't see why he would, anyway. I haven't won any of these races. No, I haven't won any of them. It's harder to win them when, like, it's harder to win them when you're doing a number of them and you're up against fresh riders. I've Everested outside. Well, no, I haven't Everested outside. I've attempted an Everest outside but failed. That was quite a few years ago. We've done two, this is the third. But the first one I was doing, we got the game crashed, so we're not going to do a fourth one now. So it's clickbait. Thank you, Giorgio. Thank you. It's the first edition. We're gonna change the EL to my actual brand logo. So it's gonna look really nice. We've got plenty of time to finalise it and make tweaks to it. So. Phil rode outside today. I think. well, when I say outside, like literally on his outside his street by Tower Bridge.
I've seen you on Strava. Calm Hunt,
while you're here, we're talking about the t-shirts, yeah? People are keen, so I'm gonna record that video today, gonna give you a lot of credit, and we're gonna let the people speak. If that sounds good to you. We might even premiere the video, because at least then we can have a chat at the side, so we can all, you know, fire some ideas in there and whatnot. I think that could be a good way of doing it, as well as obviously leaving the comments down the comment section, but also having a live chat on the premiere. What's your thoughts? Sam, there we go. Nice one. Well, I might, if I can knock it out today, I will. And premiere it later this evening. If not, we'll just do it tomorrow. But it is a weekend tomorrow, so probably most of you are going to be, more of you are going to be around on a Saturday evening, I think, than on a Friday evening, possibly. You want a bit of your own time on a Friday evening. Don't stay awake, Jim. Well, it works in some occasions, Lord. So, do you remember the British Hill Climb Championship video? That worked really well for the premiere, because everyone was like hyped for it, and they were waiting. It was almost like a film release, you know, like we'd built up to that video, and like people were just waiting for it. No, they can watch it with you. They can watch it with you. I suppose it's not that brilliant, but. Alright, we won't premiere it. Well, what we'll do, yeah, we'll premiere it, and let's premiere it for tomorrow evening then, Saturday evening, so I've got some time to knock it together properly, and it just gives us some ideas to knock together, and it gives us an opportunity going into the next couple of months to transition and to think about other things. And you guys being a part of that, and you know, Scott, Calm Hunt TV being a part of that, Phil being a part of that, Cycling Hub being a part of that, everybody in the community being a part of that, I think we can move, we can... Is my avatar bald? No, it's not. Good as for that. I tell you what is fun at 2x the speed, Mick. Watch Cam and Pritch's podcasts at 2x the speed. They're really funny. Thumbnail's spot on, Com. We'll go with it. We've got some nice sun outside today, by the way, for some pictures. Can we put peanut on a t-shirt? Is that a cord to your jacket? Can we have that on a t-shirt? Is my avatar bald? I've got all these ideas. What are we going to do with them all? Do you know what we'll have to have? You know, like, vegan cyclist has hashtag bruh. We're going to have like, the Welsh equivalent, which is hashtag cariad. Cariad means love. All right, love? All right, cariad? You all right, cariad? That's C-A-R-I-A-D, cariad. You sound normal. I'm not going to answer that. Can I watch it Scott's vids at like two times the speed? I don't think he'd ever be able to keep up with them. It would be fun though. I can't see a Loris hand down there, yeah. Here we go. Why do we have to start on everybody? Right here, Phil, look at that TV. I'm glad I'm at the front. Looking for Lawrence. I'm a bit tired. I want to go up that mountain up there. I feel this race is going to be painful on the leg snapper. I just kind of just point that out. I'm going to be in an absolute box on the leg snapper. 3 hours in, hitting the leg snapper four times. What do I do? By the way, can I say, you know when Saint Piran posted that photo of me on Instagram, you all jumped on with Ed Mode and all that. Can I just say, fair play. Because what you've done there is turned me into something that I will forever be known for.
Oh, we're going to be in a big box here. I'm going to be grimacing like a bad. Yeah, my own personal hyper. And word. Slow down. Hold the wheel, Brown. What are you doing? Yeah, that's me, David. That's me, lean. Funny how a lot of people always say like 177 centimeters or 60 kilos, 59 kilos. Yeah, whatever. I'm like, oh, that's me. You really notice the difference. When you meet me in real life, you really notice the difference. Yeah, it does, isn't it, Scott? It's the camera, isn't it? Oh, get over this in the second group. Hopefully. Mary Poppins. Nice and steady bit now, boys. Steady now, boys. Steady, steady. Whoa, whoa. Steady. Oh, a minute. Well, certainly will, Scott. One off tee, innit? A one off tee. Oh, I'm into the front group of 10.
Jeez.
That's weird. What are we doing? I know they're just going to press on. Oh man. By the way, have you seen Ted King's video recently? Where he's like riding on Zwift. It's really funny. I think it's like his first time racing on Zwift or something. See that comment? That's the one with Kevin Bouchard Hall. It's quite funny. Speak, Com Hunt, speak. I don't even remember it. I think there's nobody. Which photo was that? Which photo was that, dude? Ah, yeah. I could try and take a photo of that as well, but if I took a photo of that on my arm, they'd probably think it's on my ankle or something. They wouldn't want to use that. You know, you've got big, strong arms. They're crushing those cons. Like that. True though, my wrist is like my ankle. No lie. Yeah, I've probably got more veins in my arm than in my leg. Yeah. have no idea. It's a bit weird, isn't it? Maybe it's not him. I feel love for the first time. And it's true, I can tell by the look in your actually more chance of us winning in this group. Well, as long as we don't go hard at the leg snapper. I'm saying it's 6,000 kill. My legs. I've been in the team bus on Tour Japan, Tour Korea. Oh. Karaoke bus all the way. Give me a bit of M&M. Oh! Watch out! Alright, wish us luck. Goldie looking chain, innit? Music is my breathing.
Thank you.
Oh, made it over the second one. Oh, tell me about it, Jake. Just getting after it. Putting it in. Getting it done. Head mode. Yeah, let's roll an extra small curve. And even extra small is baggy. Yes. I just want to plug Bynea Climbers right now because the actual extra small jersey fits really well everywhere. And usually what you find is the extra small, it doesn't have enough length. So when you stand up, you can see like your fuzz, whereas it is actually quite long. Yeah, that's right, Jake. But heart rate does drop the tired, the more tired you get. At least with low intensity. Hang on to the top. Ah! It won't let me do that again. What do you mean, central? What do you mean? Zero Empires, lightest shoes in the world, or some of them anyway. I've not even got a shoe deal, dude. Bought these for 80 quid on Facebook Marketplace. Hell of a deal. Yeah, cheers. Everyone loves to ask the questions when I'm flat out. No, just the standard Empires SLX. When I told them I'm smoked, I am actually smoked, but when you ride at threshold and you're tired, it's easier for me. I'm smoked whenever I go over threshold. And I'm fine when I ride at threshold. It's not working. It's not working. See, they all do it. See, second for me is better. No. Sitting up. They just don't work with me. It just don't work with me. Let's go. Thank you. Three and a half hours. 175 TSS. We've got 271 normalized, so we've got an intensity factor of 0.75. We'll take it. We'll take it. One last look at the power graph before I jump off. Two little moves. Power it very slow to come up. Not so much the second time. Yeah, that's it, you've hit the nail on the head there. So that's why it's so hard to maintain fitness and get to the fitness, because you either have to, you know, have a lot of hours to maintain that fitness, or you have a lot of intensity. You can only handle that intensity when you're at that level. So it's very difficult to balance when, you know, you want to try and maintain it. Bad. Not bad. Nice one. Alright guys. I'm gonna get onto that video today. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, please give a thumbs up. And if you're new here, subscribe and hit that notification button next to it. The bell icon. It'll let you know whenever I'm going live, or rather let you know when there's a new video. Yeah, the fitter you get, the harder it gets. It's as simple as that. Yeah, tomorrow, hopefully, if we can dig ourselves out of a hole, and then Sunday as well. So I'll catch you very, very soon. See you later, alligators.